court is obligated to consider all of the options and all the factors laid out in Iowa Code Chapters 901 and 907, and I have done that in this case. I've considered the circumstances of the offense. I've read through the minutes of the testimony. I've read through the reports. I have to take into account the fact that you were cooperative with the authorities once this horror was revealed. I have to take into account the fact that you do have a mental health diagnosis. I understand that there may be some substance abuse factors involved, and I understand that you were essentially taken in by Mark and Misty Ray during the time that these girls were living with Mark and Misty, and perhaps you had some misplaced sense of loyalty to the Rays. But despite those factors, there's no doubt in my mind that justice cannot be served unless you serve prison time in this case. Atrocities, both large and small throughout history, have been somehow rationalized or justified because people said they were just following orders or they were just following instructions. And yet, when you see something that terrible, when you see your cousin Sabrina clearly on the verge of death and take no action whatsoever to try to save her, it makes everyone wonder, why couldn't you summon something from your heart or your soul to do the right thing, to help those girls and save them from the horror show that they witnessed when their sister died on May 12th of 2017. You had to do that. You should have done that. You didn't do that. And now you bear responsibility along with the other players in this terrible story. And it's not lost on the court that you're the third generation of women from this family that I now will have sent to the Mitchellville prison because of your role and their role in the death of Sabrina and the abuse of her two younger sisters. And it is incomprehensible. I don't know how we got here. Yes, we'll move forward. This is not the final chapter. As counsel for the state indicated, nobody will ever forget what happened to Sabrina Ray, and heaven help us if we do. But you're going to have to take responsibility and bear the pain, which is going to be, quite frankly, insignificant to the pain that was inflicted upon the children that suffered in this case, and certainly the one who eventually died. It is therefore the judgment and sentence of this court that you're to be incarcerated for an indeterminate prison term not to exceed 10 years as to count one. You'll be transported to the Iowa Correctional Facility for Women in Mitchellville by the Dallas County Sheriff. You are entitled to credit for time served as to count one and as to all counts in this matter. You'll be required to submit a DNA sample because of this felony conviction. And you'll be eligible for parole essentially immediately, but obviously there is no guarantee as to when the parole board will determine that you are fit for parole consideration in this case. I'll impose the minimum fine of $1,000 and 35% statutory surcharge, but I will suspend that fine and surcharge due to the practical consideration of your upcoming imprisonment. As to count three, child endangerment and aggravated misdemeanor, you're committed to the custody of the Department of Corrections and the Women's Correctional Facility in Mitchellville for an additional 2 years. the mandatory minimum fine of $625 plus 35% surcharge is imposed, but it'll be suspended. And the same sentence will apply as to count four, an indeterminate prison term not to exceed 2 years, along with the minimum fine and statutory surcharge, those items being suspended. Because of the unimaginable harm suffered by the children who are victims in this case, and your apparent indifference to that harm, it is only appropriate that the sentences on all three counts run consecutively for the maximum term of 14 years. The court will leave the record open with regard to any victim restitution that should be owed by you to the victims in this case, HR, MR, and JR. DNA sampling is also ordered as to counts three and four. At the request of the state, I'm going to extend the no contact order between you and the three children in this case for an initial period of 5 years. Should the children desire to maintain that no contact order further, they will be within their rights to seek an extension of that no contact order. And it's clear, obviously, that they don't want to have anything more to do with you, Ms. Bosman.
Thank you.